Good morning, students. How are you all? I hope all of you are very good and safe at home. In the previous class, we have completed the basic introduction of chapter 5, that is separation of substances. In that, we have discussed substances are of two types, pure and impure substances, and why it is important that we need to separate these substances so that we get the pure substance, so that we get the useful substance, so that we can easily remove the harmful substances from it and we can easily remove the undesirable component. Today we are going to discuss the different methods of separating the solid substances. So beta, first of all, you know that everything in our day-to-day life we are using mainly the mixtures like rice, pulses, wheat, grains, milk, everything that we are using in our day-to-day life, these are all called mixtures and they have some properties. So according to these properties like boiling point, solubility, behavior towards magnet or size of the particle, size of the components of the particle, so all these we have to note down so that we can easily separate the different components of the mixture. So today we are going to start how we can separate the solid substances. First method is hand picking. What do you mean by hand picking? Hand picking means whenever you separate any substances by using your hand. So it mainly we can separate those substances which are in smaller quantity so that we can easily separate the particular impurities that is present in that particular food item. Basically we are doing this method mainly in our rice, while cleaning our rice, our pulses or wheat. So we can easily separate if any small pieces of stones is present in that particular food item. Suppose I have this matter plate and it is filled with the pulses, as you can see. So if there is any small pieces of stone in it, I can easily separate by using my hand. So I'm sure that your mom, your mother always doing this before cooking the food so that they can show that yes, it is now safe and it is clean. So this is our day-to-day life activity, especially the ladies, they can easily do by using the hand. You can also help your mother also. This is the basic thing. You can easily separate the small pieces of stone if somehow it is present in this particular food item. So basically we can easily separate the stone pieces by using hand, and we only do when the quantity is in small. If the quantity is big, suppose if you have bag full of rice or pulses, you cannot separate by using your hand. It is very much difficult. Pura din chala jayega. You can separate the impurities. So basically we can do it only when the quantity is small enough. Okay. Next one is sieving. What do you mean by sieving? Sieving means how you can separate the different components, different impurities. How you can separate the different impurities according to the size. Sieve is a hollow vessel. It is a vessel which is having tiny holes in it. I am going to show you different sieving. As you can see, this is the first one. You can easily use by while filtering or while separating the cream from the milk. Some kuch bachcho ko malai pasand nahi hai, so they can easily separate this somehow. It is also used for straining the tea. Similarly, this is another sieving vessel which is mainly used for baking process or for purifying or for separating the gravy particles so that you can get the fine gravy while making any special dish. Next one is, this is another sieving while making the or while getting the fine flour for making the chapati. Obviously it is also available in your kitchen. You can easily check in your kitchen counter. It is also available, as I can show you the activity also. Suppose I have this flour and I am putting it in this vessel and now I am filtering it. As you can see, the fine particles can easily separate. It is in my plate. Okay. And the next particles, sorry, little bit, however it is not good, but as you can see, the coarse particles are settled at the bottom of the sieve and the fine particles we get easily on the plate. But this coarse particle is very rich in fiber. It is very good amount of roughage or fiber. So we should not remove them. That is why it is also called wheat bran. It is wheat bran which is very good in roughage. So we should not remove it. It is very good amount of fiber. Next, another sieving is, I have this iron mesh, which is mainly used for the wheat grains. Whenever we bought wheat from the market, they still have some impurities, small pieces of stone or dust particles or husk. So we have to remove them by using this large iron mesh, which is iron vessel or sieving vessel. As you can see, these have the big holes in it so that we can easily rotate backward and forward, and we can easily separate the husk particles or sand or dust, anything that is present in the wheat grains. So these are all the sieving vessels which we use according to the size of the particles. So sieving is a process to separate the different components according to the size. Similarly, if you find out that near your house, that if there is construction going on, some people need fine sand so that they can plaster the walls. So for that, they are using a big iron mesh which can easily separate the impurities, if any impurities are present in the sand. Similarly, jewelers use the sieves to separate the different pearls size. And in cashew nut factories, different cashews, some are big in size, some are small in size. So in cashew nut factories also, people use different sieving techniques. So these are all the uses of sieving. Next is winnowing. What do you mean by winnowing? Winnowing is the process of separating the husk from the grains by the help of wind. Means with the help of wind, farmers or the people that is using wheat grains, in it husk is also present. Husk ka matlab hota hai beta dry part of a grain, dry wheat outer part of a grain. So it has to be removed. So for that, the farmer or the people that is using the process of winnowing, they are using a winnowing basket so that they can easily remove the husk from the wheat grains. I am showing you the winnowing basket also. As you can see, this is the winnowing basket. It is also called chhaz in Hindi. And somehow, I am putting it, the pulses I have, as you can see, and I am trying to do it. So what happened? The husk being lighter in weight, they can easily blown away with the help of wind, and the stone and the piece of wheat grain being heavy in size, they can settle down vertically on the ground, and the farmers can easily separate the wheat grains and husk part. And this is the process of winnowing. Basically, the farmers have to stand on a ground, on a height, on a particular height, so that whenever the wind blow, it can easily blown away, because husk being very lighter in weight, and they can easily blown away with the help of wind, and the farmers can easily separate the impurities. But this is not done in small pieces of stones, because stones are very heavy, quite heavy as compared to the husk, so they cannot remove with the help of wind. Next is threshing. What do you mean by threshing? Threshing means when we separate the grains from the stalks and from the shell. What does this mean? Stalks का मतलब होता है जो किसी भी wheat grain का stem का part होता है. Bundles of stem parts. Whenever harvesting is done, farmers need to separate the stem part and the outer covering of a seed so that they get the proper amount of hay, which is a fodder which is used for the animals, for the cattle as a food, and they get the pure wheat grains also. So threshing is a process of separating the wheat grains from the stem part and from the sheaf also. What is sheaf? That is the outer covering of a seed. What they do, they collect the different wheat grains and they make a bundle. They dry it in the sun. पहले वो sun में उनको dry करेंगे, then they make the bundle of that particular crops, and then they put, they keep that bundle and hold it in a hand and beat it into a hard substance. जैसे धोबी घाट पे करते हैं ना, जो washerman होते हैं, कपड़े wash करते हैं, एक hard substance पे मारते हैं. Similarly, they still doing the same thing. They use a hard substance. They beat that particular bundle of crops or stems. And what they do, what happen? The sheaf or the stem part can easily removed, and they get the proper grain. And they also get the hay part, which is a fodder which is used for the animals. And the sheaf can easily remove. Earlier, kya hota tha? There was no machine. Nowadays, thresher machine is used for the process of threshing. But earlier, there was no machine. So they use the animals. They use the cattle or bullock carts. And what they do, they spread the entire crops in a particular space and make the cattle to use their feet and crush them again and again for a considerable time. So what would happen? The outer covering of the wheat grains completely removed and they get the pure wheat grains. So this is all the different methods of separating the solid substances. Go and read the topic, and after that we will discuss how we can separate the liquid particles or liquid substances. Till then, be happy and try to read your topic. Bye everyone. Thank you so much.